Good morning students. Today we are going to see chapter 13 warehousing. In this lesson we will see about what is warehouse, what is warehousing and the different types of warehouses and the functions of warehouses. What is warehousing? So ware means products or goods. Warehousing, godowns, we can store the goods, that is called warehousing, and these godowns will be located near the factory. In the godowns we can keep the raw materials and also finished products. So godowns also we can call storage place, that is holding place. When the goods are not needed immediately, the goods will be stored in one place, that is godowns, that is called warehousing. And this storing of goods will be helpful to protect the goods from damage. If any damage will happen, no, for that reason the goods will be stored in the godowns. Next, warehouse. Warehouse is a place where we can store the goods for future use, that is for our future purpose we can store the goods in a place, that is called warehouse. It also act as distribution centers and it can be designed depends upon the product's nature. So how the product will be, for example, fruits and vegetables are the perishable items. Perishable means it will go bad quickly, so that is called perishable items, and cold storages are required. And for example, medicines should be kept under suitable temperature. So these, regarding these aspects, the warehouse will be designed upon the product's nature. Warehouse is a commercial building for storage of goods. So these goods can include raw materials, packing materials, spare parts, finished goods, etc. So according to J. Stephenson, warehouse is an establishment for the storage or accumulation of goods. Again I am repeating, warehousing means storage place or godowns which is located near the factory to keep the raw materials and finished products. This will be very helpful to protect the products from damage. Next, we are going to see difference between warehouse and warehousing. Warehouse is a place where we can store the goods for future use, but warehousing is an arrangement of goods. The place is called godown and this godowns will be located near the factories. Next one, it holds goods for storing purpose only, but warehousing helps to protect the goods from damage. Need for warehousing. First one, mass production. So big level of production of goods takes place by establishing big factories and also modern factories. It includes a big level of production and also modern production. So warehouses are to be built at different places to store these type of modern products and also big level products. Next, nature of commodities. As I said before, some goods will be perishable soon in nature, fruits and vegetables, medicines, etc. So for storing these perishable items, cold storage are required. So cold storage, it will extend the life of the particular perishable products. Next, seasonal production but regular consumption. Consumption means usage, how much consumers are using the particular product. So some products will be produced only in seasons, for example wheat, sugar, pulses, etc. But their usage will spread throughout the year. If proper storage facilities are not provided, the goods will automatically become destroyed and the particular product may become not usable. Next, regular production but seasonal consumption. For example, raincoats, blankets, umbrella, these will be produced in the seasons, but their consumption usage will be regular, that is throughout the year. They can be released in large quantities to meet the heavy demand during winter and rainy seasons. Next, proximity to production centers. Production of goods at specific centers need to be supplied in time throughout the country. For this purpose only, goods are regularly fed to the warehouses situated at different market areas. Next, we are going to see types of warehouses. There are two types, based on the ownership and based on the commodities stored. Based on the ownership, we have 7: private warehouse, government warehouse, public warehouse, cooperative warehouse, bonded warehouse, institutional warehouse and distribution center warehouse. Private warehouse. These warehouses are built and owned by the private business organization and this is for storing their products and this is only for their own use and not for any other manufacturing organizations. Next, public warehouse. Most of the business organization, especially small scale and medium scale units, cannot afford to have their own warehouse. They may be owned by an individual or some agency. These warehouses operate the rules and regulations formed by the government. Next, government warehouse. These warehouses are created and operated by the government. Their services mostly available to government only. For example, we can take Food Corporation of India. Next, cooperative warehouse. These warehouses are managed by the agricultural cooperative societies and they provide some facilities to the members who are in the cooperative societies. For example, National Cooperative Development Corporation. Bonded warehouse. These warehouses are licensed by the government and this was particularly for storage of imported goods which are not cleared due to the non-payment of customs. Bank loans can be obtained by submitting the receipt issued by these warehouses. Next, institutional warehouses. Banks, railways, these are some of the institutions which have their own warehouses for conducting their activities. And various transport agencies also maintain the warehouse for storing their products. Next, distribution center warehouses. These warehouses are owned by the manufacturer or wholesalers. Manufacturer means one who produces the product. So in this type of warehouse, goods which need to be temporarily stored for the temporarily storing purpose, in this distribution center, they can store the products. Next, we are going to see the second type of warehouses on the basis of commodities stored. General warehouse, special commodity warehouse, cold storage or refrigerated warehouse, climate controlled warehouse. First one, general warehouse. In this type of warehouse, products like dry food grains, fertilizers and protective measures against rat, insects, etc. are stored in this warehouse. These are also called ordinary warehouse. Next, special commodity warehouse. In this type of warehouse, products like tobacco, cotton, wool, etc. can be stored, and storage of petrol and oil requires special type of vertical cylindrical storage tanks. So such type of products will be stored in this special commodity warehouse. Next, cold storages or refrigerated warehouse. Goods which are transported in refrigerated containers, they are stored in the refrigerated warehouse. For example, perishable goods we can take fruits, vegetables, eggs, butter, fish, meat, etc. Next, climate controlled warehouse. Delicate products like flowers we can store in this type of climate controlled warehouse. Some climatic conditions will reduce the rate of metabolism in fruits and vegetables. Such type of products also stored. Automated warehouse. This we can handle several hundreds of kilograms of product at a time. For example, platforms that hold large amount of product. For this particular warehouse, we need to require huge investment, latest technology, and large turnover of goods. Next, functions of warehouses. First one, storage. The goods should be stored properly for the purpose of supplying them. Some goods can be destroyed quickly, some will take time. There is a time gap between the production time and the consumption time. Consumption means usage. And also there is a gap between demand and supply. So the goods should be stored properly. Next, price stabilization. Based on the demand, the price value will be fixed and also supplies the goods at more or less uniform prices throughout the year. Next, equalization of demand and supply. Warehousing equalizes both demand and supply. When they are not in demand, it will keep the goods itself, and when they are in demand, it will release the goods. So the consumers get the commodities regularly, even in the off-season periods. Next, business finance. In this, depositor can get loan. So how much goods are deposited in the warehouse, with that receipt he can get the loan from the financial institutions and from banks. Next, risk bearing. In case of any damage to the goods which are in the warehouse, if any damage occurs, means the warehouse keeper compensate the loss. Thus, warehouse bear the loss of risk involved in the storage of goods. Next, preparation for sale. Warehouse also involves in the preparation for sale. It undertakes the function of sorting the product, packing the product, and labeling the product. Finally, making the goods suitable for marketing process. Next, widening the market area. So how the manufacturer for the marketing areas, he is opening the branch. Likewise, he can also establish branch warehouses or rental warehouses. Thus, warehousing widens the market for the goods. Last one, value added services. Sometimes the goods are repacked and labeled again at the time of inspection by prospective buyers. It also, warehouses also provide certain value added services. The value added services are grading, packaging, and labeling. For this purpose, it has to do the packaging process and labeling process again at the time of inspection by the prospective buyers.